Blackstone Audio presents The House of Blue Mangoes by Davidar. In loving memory of my mother, Sushila Davidar, and for my wife, Rachna Singh. A Land of Miracles and Fire, Marina Tsvetaeva. Book 1, Chevathar. 1. Spring, 1899. As the ordinary violence of dawn sweeps across the lower Coromandel coast, a sprawling village comes into view. The turbulent sky excepted, everything about it is tranquil. Away to the west, a great headland, thickly maned with coconut palms, juts into the sea, partially enclosing a deserted beach on which long, slow swells, clear and smooth as glass, break with scarcely a sound. Beyond the beach, the waters of an estuary reflect the rage of colour overhead. This is where the Chevathar, the country's southernmost river and the source of the village's name, prepares for its final run to the sea. On a bluff overlooking the estuary, almost hidden by coconut palms, is a small church. From there, the village straggles upriver for about a mile and a half, ending at the bridge that connects it to the town of Meenakshikoil on the opposite bank. Through the village runs a narrow tarred road that stands out like a fresh scar on the red soil. The road connects all Chevathar's major landmarks, the Vedar quarter to the north, the ruins of an 18th-century mud fort, Vakil Perumal's two-story house with its bone-white walls, the Amman and the Murgan temples, and on a slight elevation, the house of the thalaivar, Solomon Dorai, barely visible behind a fringe of casuarina trees and coconut palms. Surrounding the walls of the big house, as it is known, are several trees that aren't usually seen in the area. A tall, umbrella-shaped rain tree, a breadfruit tree with leaves that explode in green star-shaped clusters, and many jackfruit trees laden with heavy, spiky fruit that spring directly from the trunk. These are the results of the labours of Charity Dorai, who does not come from these parts. In an effort to allay her homesickness, she began planting trees from her homeland. 20 years later, they have altered the treescape of Chevathar. Down to the river from the big house tumble groves of Chevathar Neelam, a rare hybrid of a mango native to the south. The trees are astonishingly beautiful, the fruit glinting blue against the dark green leaves. The locals will tell you that the Chevathar Neelam, which has made the Dorai name famous throughout the district, is so sweet that after you've eaten one, you cannot taste sugar for at least 3 days, so the locals say. The rest of the village is quickly described. More coconut palms, the Paracheri to the southwest, a few shops by the bridge over the Chevathar River, the huts of the Andavar tenant farmers close to the road, and a dozen or so wells and tanks that raise blind, glittering eyes to the morning light. The villagers rise early, but as it's some way yet before the fields are to be prepared for the transplanting of rice, the men are not up and about. Most of the women have risen before dawn and are racing to finish their household chores. Today the village celebrates the Panguni Otiram festival, and they're hoping to snatch a few minutes at the festive market that's being assembled, bright and tawdry, by the walls of the Murgan temple. Movement on the tarred road. 2 girls, 1 13 and soon to be married, the other a year younger, are on their way to the fair. They are dressed in their best clothes, the older girl in a violet half-sari jasmine in her well-oiled and plaited hair, her cousin in a garish pink skirt. Their foreheads are adorned with sandalwood paste, vibhuti and kumkumam from the Amman temple, where they worshipped before dayfall. They walk quickly, even though they're very early, their feet light on the deliciously cool road, eager to get to the market. The older girl has been given 4 annas to spend by her mother. It's a small sum, but it's more money than Valle has ever had before, and she can barely contain her excitement at what she might be able to buy with it. Bangles? Earrings? Silk for a blouse, perhaps, or might that be too expensive? Parvati hurries to keep up with her cousin. The girls pass a grey outcrop of granite polished by wind and rain to a smooth, rounded shape that resembles the knobbly forehead of an elephant. Anekal, as it is called, is popular with children playing hide-and-seek, but they barely register...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.